breakfast.
Is this all there is? There's just fruit, tea, and Danish. There's no bacon.
I call it a continental breakfast.
I call it a cheapo breakfast.
I heard that.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Peninsula Regional Medical Center is proud to be recognized as a national healthcare leader, delivering exceptional healthcare by exceptional people. The professional staff at PRMC is equipped to handle most injuries and illnesses that are non-life-threatening and can deliver immediate medical attention without an appointment. To get more information and up to the second wait times, visit peninsula.org. PRMC, proud to be the official healthcare provider of the UMES Hawks.
Do you need a break, a getaway? Plan a visit to Hyatt Place Dewey Beach in Delaware. Lay back, relax with your toes in the sand, and unwind to the sounds of the ocean. Please your palate with a delicious meal at Cape Hasa Restaurant on the bay while taking in the sights of a beautiful sunset. It's time to get away and make that getaway to the Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. Call 302-864-9100 or visit HyattPlaceDeweyBeach.com. Make a lifetime of memories in your own backyard at Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. That's Hyatt Place Dewey Beach on Facebook and Instagram.
Bobby, you're here again!
Yeah. Yeah, my doctor told me to reduce stress at work, so I come to Buffalo Wild Wings to eat lunch and watch sports. I get to pick one of seven entrees, like sandwiches and salads, plus one of seven sides.
Well, I like sides.
It's so affordable, I can finally take a vacation.
Where are you gonna go?
Here, Tim, here.
Introducing the new B-Dubs Fast Break Lunch Menu, starting at a new low price. Dine in or order takeout weekdays between 11 and 2. Participation and availability may vary. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
This is the Hawk Sports Network from sfmsports.net. Tip-off is minutes away. This gives you time to save 15% on your car insurance with Geico. 15 minutes is all it takes. Now, back to the Geico All-Access Pregame Show from sfmsports.net.
Morgan State and Maryland Eastern Shore, about 5 minutes from the pregame clock expiring, where they'll give you the starting lineups. No anthem. We had it before the women's game earlier. And then we'll have the opening tip. Todd Bozeman has his group out there tonight, and they are certainly eager to get off to a better start in conference play. Last year, they just went 5-11 in the MEAC for a team they were really hoping that, you know, they could have a better season than that.
And they usually do. They've been in the hunt over the years that Coach Bozeman's been there. So that was kind of unexpected. So I'm sure they're looking for a bounce back year, and we're going to see tonight.
Well, they had a couple of NCAA tournament appearances in 2009 and in 2010 when they won back-to-back MEAC championships. They lost the MEAC championship game in 11 after going 17-14, had a down year, 9-20 in 2012. But each of the last 2 years, they were right around the 500 mark. I should say the 2 years after that, in 2013 and in 2014, they were right around the 500 mark, lost in the MEAC championship round both years before last year really struggling. 7-24. Just, again, goes to your point. This is a team with a winning tradition that, for whatever reason, just had a bad year a year ago, and they're trying to get back this year.
That's right. And I'm sure everybody in Maryland and are looking for the same thing.
Meanwhile, Bobby Collins has his group about as motivated as you can be. There have been some games lately where I know UMES has gone into the game. They've played at a pretty good level, especially in their most recent contest when they squared off at Columbia. It was a six-point final score, but keep in mind that two of those 81 points were free throws with two-tenths of a second left. Columbia basically won the game by one possession. It was a 3-4-point game, something in that ballpark, for the last 6 or 7 minutes of the game. In fact, it was actually the first time all year that the Hawks lost a game where they had a lead within the last 5 minutes of the contest. So a back-and-forth game down the stretch. They just ran out of gas a little bit, but that three-headed monster of Martin, Elliott, and Copeland really did play well. They had 61 total points.
Yes. They played well, but the Hawks are looking for somebody, you know, just to help them out a little bit, because that can't possibly happen every single night. And they're still, again, that three-headed monster is up front, so the Hawks are looking for some good guard play from Alvarado and somebody else coming off the bench. They have to get that in order to win.
Well, Derek Opek, Brian Andino, Dante Caldwell, those are guys that at times this year have shown ability to put up double-digit efforts, but it hasn't been consistent. To your point about needing leads this stat. So Bakari Copeland, Dominique Elliott, and Devin Martin have combined this year to score at least 10 points 36 times. Everybody else on the team has combined to score at least 10 points only 8 times all season long. So you know you're going to get that kind of offense from your best players, but you've got to get some other contributions.
You got to get a little bit. I mean, you got to get somebody, you know, you got to get somebody coming off, throw down 8 or 9, 10 points for you. You got to get some consistency at the guard position. That's, you know, the couple guys that are playing the guard, they got to come up with this. If you can do that, then that's called team basketball. You know, three guys do not constitute a basketball team, so you have to have production from more than three.
Well, last time these two teams met, it was senior night here in this building. Oregon State fell 89-76 to your Hawks, who climbed to 11-5 to finish the regular season in conference play. Mike Myers, Dominique Elliott, both had double-doubles. Morgan State's Cedric Blossom, and of course, Devin Martin for the Hawks, both had 17 points in that ballgame. Coaching staffs are out on the floor. The players have finished their pregame warm-ups. We'll take our final timeout and this when we return. UMES of Morgan Statue when we return. This is the Hawk Sports Network on SFMSports.net.
Before I posted a picture of my friend at his bachelor party, I should have known to check. I also should have known about privacy settings. I did not. Now I know. Just like I should have known that GEICO has a 97% customer satisfaction rating and they have a local agent right here in Baltimore. No wonder they're the number one auto insurer in Maryland. We should all know these things. Now I know. And now you know. And now my friend's mom knows too much.
GEICO. Thank you, Baltimore, for making us number one.
Now that you know GEICO has a local agent in your area, sit back, relax, and let me tell you how they could help. Our GEICO agents run locally owned and operated businesses and can help tailor your policy to your specific needs. Whether you're looking to insure your car, motorcycle, or RV, the GEICO Insurance Agency could also help you save money on homeowners and renters coverage. Did you sit back? Are you relaxed? Now pay attention. You're driving.
GEICO. To get a free rate quote, go to geico.com. Then buy online, over the phone, or at your local office.
Yesterday, I was embarrassed to have guests use my bathroom. Today, I can't wait to show it off. What a difference a day makes. It started with a simple phone call to Quick Bath Remodel Center. They connected us to a free in-home design consultation. We chose the style and color we wanted and then turned our old mildewy shower and tub into a luxurious shower we love. The remodel was quick, done in just one day. Here's the best part. Quick Bath Remodel Center referred us to factory-trained installers who handled everything for us. They custom made our new walk-in shower to fit our existing bathroom space. Our home is not only more beautiful, it's more valuable too. Imagine getting a beautiful new bathroom you'll love in just one day. We did it, and so can you, when you call Quick Bath Remodel Center today.
Call 800-870-3137. That's 800-870-3137. 800-870-3137. Call today, 800-870-3137.
Before we give you the starting lineups for the Maryland Eastern Shore Hawks and Morgan State Bears, let's pause 10 seconds for a station identification. You're listening to the Hawks Sports Network on SFMSports.net. And Coach Dave Bird with you as we get ready for tonight's game between Maryland Eastern Shore and Morgan State. A quick look at the starting lineups for Morgan State first. Senior guard Dante Pretlow will get the start, along with senior guard Rashawn Simpson and senior forward Cedric Blossom. Sophomore forward Philippe Carr and freshman guard Martez Cameron. Morgan State, led by head coach Todd Bozeman, is a 1986 grad of Rhode Island. And for the Maryland Eastern Shore Hawks, senior guard Devin Martin, freshman guard Ahmad Frost, senior forward Dominique Elliott, junior guard Bakari Copeland, and junior forward Shane Randall. Leader of the Hawks is head coach Bobby Collins, his second year out of Eastern Kentucky. Well, before we get into the start of the game, what are your thoughts? What do you think?
I think it's going to be an even ball game again. We might be seeing another overtime. It's that close.
We'll find out. Hopefully in just a few minutes from now, Morgan State takes the floor in their bright orange jerseys, orange tops, orange shorts, navy trim, navy numbers. Says Morgan State on the front, no names on the back. UMES, white tops, white shorts with maroon trim numbers and letters. They do have names on the back of their jerseys. Dominique Elliott will jump center. And going up against him will be 6'6 senior Rashawn Simpson. Ready to go as conference action gets back on the floor here tonight. Elliott wins the opening tip. Hawks control, and we're underway in Princess Anne, Maryland. UMES goes left to right in the first half. If you're watching on our video on YouTube, again, the Hawks in white, Morgan State in orange. Ahmad Frost gets another start. Third straight game that he's had a start. Runs the point. Thomas Rivera will come off the bench tonight. Elliott, low left post, likes to shoot it from there. He's a little short with it. Morgan State clears it away. That was Blossom on the rebound. He's probably one of the best players for the visiting Bears. Blossom with the ability to shoot long-range jump shots as well, but he likes to penetrate inside. He works to the left side of the floor where it's dribbled around for just a moment by Martez Cameron. And a foul up top as Cameron went to his right.
Pretty easy. Shane Randall just knocked him back about 10 feet around the three-point line.
By the way, to take care of some housekeeping for our affiliates, our next break will be break number 4 so that we can stay on schedule here with all of our commercials tonight. So no score. It's the opening possession of the game for Morgan State. Hawks did not score their first time. Up top, here's an in-rhythm three. It circles around but doesn't fall for Pretlow. Rebound loose on the floor, and how about that effort from the Bears? Wow. Simpson just ripped it away from a couple of Hawks. Jump ball, so it stays with the Bears as the crowd continues to file in. We've got a pretty good crowd on hand tonight, many of them sticking around after the women's game wrapped up with a Bears overtime victory. Almost a travel in front of the Hawks bench. The Bears control it with basically the full shot clock. Passed into the left corner. Simpson got it from 12 feet away. Rashawn Simpson, his first bucket. Yeah.
Full court press now by the Bears. 2-2-1.
This has been where the Hawks have struggled this year when they've faced a zone full court press, and the Bears throw it at them right away. Elliott up at the top of the arc. Remember, he had a double-double against these guys in his last time out. Feeds Randall underneath. Shane goes to work into a double team. Out to Copeland. Three ball coming. Got it.
Wide open jump shot from behind the arc.
Copeland has played well the last six games after a good start to the season and then quite a long lull. But he seems to have found his rhythm. And, boy, the Hawks need him to keep that up. Right corner, Simpson back to the top of the arc. Jump shot coming. Drained from Blossom.
And Blossom can do that. He's a good overall, well-rounded player.
Very good in-rhythm shooter. Half the length of the floor on the pass. Elliott strong to the hole. He put it in. One more coming. Great feed from Devin Martin all the way up the whole floor.
Yeah, full court pass by Martin. Dominic finished it with the and one coming up.
You might recall early in the season, Elliott, his first two games, picked up two fouls in the first 3 minutes and the first 6 minutes against Kansas State and Missouri. But he really hasn't had that kind of an issue since then. He's had a couple games where maybe he picked up two first half fouls as he hits the free throw to give his team a two-point lead.
But not so early.
But not so early in the game that he's been a non-factor. And that has led to UMES really growing on the offensive side of things. Philippe Carr strong into the lane, right-handed hook shot off the mark, tipped around back to Carr, and he's hit on the way up.
The offensive rebounds by the Bears two times down to four now. Both teams full court pressing, by the way. Very interesting on that point.
Philippe Carr. It's spelled like you would think Philip, but pronounced Philippe. 6'8", 200-pound sophomore out of Brooklyn. So Carr goes to the free throw line, where he'll try to put up a couple shots, which could tie the game. Carr's first one, not going to fall. Carr, third leading scorer on the team, just under 10 a game. Blossom, Kyle Thomas, who will come off the bench. Carr and Andrew Horn will also come off the bench. All three of them are at 9.5 or more per night, so pretty good balance. Carr splits the pair. It's a 6-5 game. Frost running the point with the rec specs. Surveys the offense. Hawks are only playing in their third game in the new calendar year here on the 11th of January. Copeland from the right wing to the top of the arc. Lost the handle as he tried to spin around. 10 on the clock. Frost bounces to Randall. Low left post. Faces up. Fakes. Strong move inside. Missed the right-handed runner. Morgan State the other way. Quickly flying up the floor and good active hands by Ahmad Frost. Jars the ball loose from Cameron. We got a jump ball and it goes back to the Hawks.
Both teams on the ball after on the floor after the ball. Good hustle. And the Bears look like they want to push it. Absolutely.
Actually, I take that back. Not a jump ball. I guess Morgan State was able to call timeout. They felt, or the officials felt, that Morgan State had possession. So it will be MSU basketball. Our officials in this one, Duke Edsel, James Foster, and Olandis Poole. So just a couple minutes in, 17-11 left in the first half. Like the energy so far early in the game, but boy, it's been one of those contests so far where both teams have been thrown to the wolves.
Yeah, we're going at it pretty good. We got a out-of-bounds play underneath their own basket for the Bears. 1-3-1 set offensively.
Cameron trying to get it in, and he chucks it into the backcourt where the Hawks were willing to give that pass up. Back to the right corner. Jump shot. Blossom, no. And the putback. How did Carr slip in there and tip that one in? 7-6 lead for Morgan State as they crash the boards.
It's their third offensive rebound, though. That's not a good sign.
3 minutes in. Hawks down one. Copeland fakes from three left wing. Goes to the hoop and beautifully puts it in. I don't know where the light switch went off for Copeland, but it off about 3 weeks ago. And he made it be a better player getting to the rim. Morgan State answers with a layup from Martez Cameron. 9-8, UMES down one on their home floor, 3.5 minutes in. Martin gets some help as he was trapped across the midcourt stripe. He raises from three after getting it back, and he'll shoot three free throws. Cameron hits Martin, and so the free throws will come from the senior. I'll tell you what. Devin Martin has figured for UMES this year, playing at a very high level. Martin is averaging 25 points per game over his last six contests, including two 30-point efforts and a career-high 37 at one point. Martin got the first of the three to drop to tie the game at 9 apiece. We got a free throw coming in just a moment for Morgan State.
First point of the night, Martin
retired. 9-9 ball game as Devin stares at the hard court while dribbling the ball. It's up and good again. Andre Horn Jr. checks in. So does Kyle Thomas.
4 points, too. He's been making free throws at a high rate also.
All the time. Cameron and Simpson are the two that check out of the game. Yeah, Martin has really found himself at the stripe a lot lately. Almost double-digit free throws in those last six games. He's gotten to the line at least six times, and he's averaging 9 a game. 11-9 as the Hawks get all three there from the stripe. Into the forecourt, Morgan State controls right side. Pretlow, double-teamed, zings one to the left. This is Horn Jr. back to him. To the right side now. Blossom bobbles it, picks it back up. 10 to shoot. And Ahmad Frost with a little bit of a reach around. His first personal.
You can't do that right in front of the official.
No, that's not the time to do that.
About 2 feet away.
Comes Ryan Andino into the ball game. And Shane Randall will have a seat. We've seen that a lot. Randall comes into the game as a starter, and then from that point forward, seems to not play quite as often. He did get a lot of minutes, though, last contest. By the way, that was the fourth foul already this half for the Hawks. Ball coming, it rattles in. Popped halfway out, then Horn got it to drop in. 12 to 11, Morgan State. And Dino is a dangerous sharp left side underneath the Copeland in for two. 13-12 Hawks.
Good pass. Martin drew the defense. Little give to Copeland.
15-30 left in the first half. We'll pause at our next stoppage. Carr from the right side, up and good. 14-13.
Both teams nice offensive moves out there now. Full court press centers in.
Court with his home white son. Staring down Carr, he passes left. Frost feeds Elliott, who slips one to the right side, and he's touching it, and Copeland is fouled as he tried to drive the baseline. Andre Horn hit him. So that's a foul. The second team foul on at a timeout. 5 minutes gone by. Hawks down 14-13. This is the Hawks Sports Network on sfmsports.net.
The Courtyard by Marriott on Route 13 in Salisbury offers comfortable rooms and meeting spaces, as well as always superior customer service in a great location near the mall. Call 410-742-4405 and ask for details about their special UMES athletics rate. The Courtyard by Marriott in Salisbury, an official hotel of UMES Athletics and a proud sponsor of Hawks basketball from sfmsports.net.
Peninsula Regional Medical Center is proud to be recognized as a national healthcare leader, delivering exceptional healthcare by exceptional people. The professional staff at PRMC is equipped to handle most injuries and illnesses that are non-life-threatening and can deliver immediate medical attention without an appointment. To get more information and up to the second wait times, visit peninsula.org. PRMC, proud to be the official healthcare provider of the UMES Hawks.
This is Hawks Basketball from sfmsports.net.
14-13, Morgan State leads about 5 minutes into the ballgame. Brendan Gulick and Coach Dave Bird with you. Thanks for tuning in tonight, and we hope you've got us on in the background. And tweet at us or something and give us half time of our game. We'll see. Title game. Well, okay.
You know how that
8-17,
yeah,
or whatever they're gonna put it. Yeah,
yeah, right.
It's about. Please don't go away. Title game. His left thumb. The all backward floor. After the Horn is out there. Three. It's Ben. Some man defense. He's
a little off balance for that shot by Dominic fading back. A little offensive.
Carr in the corner goes toward that right wing. Carr making his way through the paint, kicks out. Horn for three. Rattled it in. That's a couple for him now from that left side of the arc. 17-13, Morgan State. Timeline. Thomas Rivera on the right wing, lobs it into Dominique Kelly. Dom on the right side of the key, skips over to Rivera, who fakes left, drives right to the hoop, gives underneath to Martin. Beautiful, beautiful pass. Great vision by the junior point guard.
Good penetration, fake the three-point shot, pass.
Nelson. Morgan State swinging the ball around the arc. In the 15. By the way, we're going to have some problems statistically in the first half. We'll try to get you some updated stats by the time the second half rolls around, but Thomas Rivera does a good job. Thomas Rivera with that layup makes it 20-17. Morgan State races up the floor and missed the layup. Both of these teams playing with a lot of energy here early on. A couple of passes as Rivera goes sprawling to save one. And Dino fakes from three, pulls up left elbow, and missed a little left. The rebound comes down to Rashawn Simpson. Bears zigging it up the floor quickly. Missed layup from Cox. Totally uncontested. A two-handed layup running in the left baseline.
I don't know what he was.
And he missed it.
He missed it totally.
Just a lack of concentration. Copeland, Martin, Rivera, Andino, and Elliott out there for the men in white. On what I think was supposed to be an alley-oop pass, Elliott had it thrown behind him. The ball, he was fouled. Lots of new faces. Kyle Thomas with his first team four. So we'll just reset the group for you on the floor. Dante Caldwell, Shane Randall both check in. They're out there with Andino, Rivera, and Martin. So a smaller group with Randall as the only forward out there. Morgan State with Horn, Carr, Pretlow, Thomas, and Blossom out there. Rivera at the top of the key, looking left. 12-20 left opening frame. 20-17. Morgan State on top. Caldwell left corner, thought about it, came up top to Martin instead. Devin, a hesitation dribble through the paint, stops. Out to Caldwell for a deep three. Dante missed it. Randall tries to bring in the rebound. It tipped off his hand to a bear. Instead, it's Clive CJ, as they like to call him, Vaughn in the right corner. Blossom swings left side. Horn holding at his right, or rather, that's not Horn, but Simpson holding at his right hip. Little bit short. And a ball thrown off a Hawk out of bounds.
Timeout coming up.
So a timeout on the floor, and Morgan State will regroup as they have a three-point lead at 20-17. 11:41 left here in the first quarter. This is the Hawk Sports Network on SFMSports.net.
Consider the cup holder. There's probably one feeling empty next to you right now. No Pepsi, no hope. Just look at it, won't you? All across the country, cup holders are being neglected. Instead of Pepsi, they're being filled with loose change or crumpled up receipts. But you can help. Get a Pepsi and refresh a cup holder's life. Our thirsts are counting on it. In fact, I'm having one right now. That is refreshing. Pepsi, refresh yourself. Refill your cup holder.
Do you need a break, a getaway? Plan a visit to Hyatt Place Dewey Beach in Delaware. Lay back, relax with your toes in the sand, and unwind to the sounds of the ocean. Please your palate with a delicious meal at Cape Hasa Restaurant on the bay while taking in the sights of a beautiful sunset. It's time to get away and make that getaway to Dewey Beach. Call 302-864-9100 or visit HyattPlaceDeweyBeach.com. Make a lifetime of memories in your own backyard at Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. That's Hyatt Place Dewey Beach on Facebook and Instagram.
Get UMES Hawks basketball anywhere. Listen on your phone with the TuneIn app. Search SFM Sports Channel 2.
UMES trailing 20-17 in our first half. 11:41 left. Would go to the locker room and talk about things. Well, so far, both teams shooting the ball okay. And again, we've got some statistical problems. We won't be able to give you accurate information on stats until at least halftime. But we'll work through those. Partman is the best play-by-play, that's truly it. Without any stats.
We'll tell you what happened without stats and just take a few...
A few of your tidbits along the way.
That's right.
Morgan State working the ball around the perimeter. Yeah. Into the left corner. Young freshman moves it around back to the right side. Kyle Thomas back to the left wing now. Cameron bounces low left post. Skip pass right side. Three ball coming. And Vaughn missed it. Elliott rips away the rebound and a foul called. I think it's on Morgan State. That is correct. It's on Rashawn Simpson, a senior from sunny San Diego, California. UMS got to lock it up. Fifth foul against Morgan State. 20-17. The Bears on top by three. It's a big game for both of these two teams as Caldwell helps break the press in time. Both teams looking to get off to a good start here in conference play. Morgan State wants the weekend sweep. They beat Delaware State on Saturday. First contest of the year between these two here today. Elliott was about to lose one out of bounds, and in the backcourt, Caldwell runs it down, but it's technically an over and back.
Caldwell had to do that, or Martez Cameron would have got an easy layup.
10:53 left in the half, 20-17 MSU, and they have a baseline inbound in the forecourt. Bobby Collins in his thick navy suit tonight. That's a deep navy color. Staying with his hands in his pockets in front of his bench, watching his defense here. Cameron, baseline jumper, left side is pure. 22-17 MSU, back to a full court press.
Cameron, fresh.
Rivera almost turned it over in the backcourt. Good defense. Ian Caldwell breaking in time. Thomas pressured right of center. Trying to read the offense while Cameron bothers him. Thomas to the left side as Devin Martin waits to check back in. Andino catch and shoot three. Missed it from dead on. Cedric Blossom grabs the rebound. Morgan State up the right side of the floor. Into the corner. Back up top to Blossom. Quick pass left side. Carr. Double teamed. Needs some help. Almost threw it away. Blossom spins. Passes off. Jumper from the right side of the elbow. And it's good from Rashawn Simpson.
Blossom doing it all. Rebound on one end. Assist on the other end. A good all-around player in the media.
Good patience for the Morgan State offense. They lead 24-17. Rivera. Near the full court for UMES, down by a game-high 7 points. Isaac Taylor working in the post with Elliott. Freshman from Wachapreek, Virginia, setting the screen. Dom wants to go inside to him and threw it away. Here come the Bears, 2-on-3, and it's pulled out. Antonio Gillespie pulls it out. Caldwell tips it loose. He's got a fast break opportunity, and he just slips it over the front of the rim. He explodes toward the rim. 24-19, Hawks down 5. Morgan State's got the ball back. Carr gives over to the left side. Gillespie into the corner. Cameron dribbles right-handed back to the top of the arc. They swing right corner. Well, the Bears move the ball quickly on offense, and it's created some open shots for him here in the first half.
And the Hawks playing man-to-man defense at this point.
Just 9 minutes left in this first half and a traveling violation in that right corner. And Antonio Gillespie turns it over at the 8:58 mark. So Devin Martin comes back in. Let's see.
Both freshmen going out of game for Morgan.
Caldwell and Taylor, two freshmen that check out for UMES. So Cedric Blossom and Philip Carr, or I should say Philippe Carr, are going to be the two in the forecourt for Morgan State. They've got three guards and two forwards out there. It's now Elliott, Copeland, Andino, Rivera, and Martin. UMES down a handful. Copeland up top. Looking to his left. Rivera bobbles the ball, double teamed, and it goes out of bounds off of Bear.
The Bears are playing a 2-3 zone, but it's spread out over the entire floor. They're marking the shooters, Martin and Andito on the wings.
Only 5 on the shot clock. That's a lot of respect for the
shooters.
Hawks, who've done a good job the last 6 games or so from the outside. But they are primarily a good inside team. Martin lobs inbounds to Elliott. He fades away, left baseline, does that all the time, and hits that one. Elliott, a pretty good mid-range jump shooter for his size. 24-21, spin into the paint, and a foul.
Very quick to the basket.
These guys aren't messing around on either end of the floor.
No.
Both teams definitely came to play tonight, and you get the sense that both of them are out there feeling like, hey, you know what?
We
played some seriously tough competition this year, and I think they're excited to play against a team they feel is maybe a little more on their level. Carr at the stripe, up by 3, and it stays that way. He missed the first one short. Carr on the season, 73% from the free throw line, 38 of 52. On the way up, and he missed that one too.
Wow.
Carr with several double-digit scoring efforts this year. His best was a 20-point game, and he's had a nice positive start here early on. There was an offensive foul underneath, and I think it's on Dominique Kelly.
Yeah, he's using that arm to...
Elliott, I think, is about to check out here. That's his second. So Derek Opek going to take his spot. 8-10 left first half, 24-21.
Dominic trying to clear space with that offhand. You can't do that.
Dante Pretlow into the forecourt, averaging more than four assists per game, one of the premier point guards in the MEAC. Working out there with Simpson, who wants to go backdoor. Instead, hands Pretlow left wing. Pass to Carr right side, fakes left, drives back to the left side, a pass and a shot, and a bucket. Rashawn Simpson for two, left corner.
Yeah, mid-range jump shot for Simpson.
26-21, Morgan State, 7:40 left in the first half. Rivera finds Martin, who had a little time to think about some things, and he traveled on his way to the hoop. Another turnover, and Bobby Collins says, hey guys, let's center composure here. Let's slow down a bit. Hawks trail by a handful, 7:39 to play first half. You're listening to the Hawks Sports Network on sfmsports.net.
Bobby, you here again?
Yeah, my doctor told me to reduce stress at work, so I come to Buffalo Wild Wings to eat lunch and watch sports. I get to pick one of seven entrees, like sandwiches and salads, plus one of seven sides.
Well, I like sides.
It's so affordable, I can finally take a vacation.
Where are you going to go?
Here, Tim, here.
Introducing the new B-Dubs Fast Break Lunch Menu, starting at a new low price. Dine in or order takeout weekdays between 11 and 2. Participation and availability. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
The Hampton Inn and Suites Fruitland Salisbury South is passionate about getting it right. Their promise to you includes a clean, comfortable, located only 7.5 miles from the University of Maryland Eastern Shore. Also conveniently located within walking distance of five different restaurants, plus a shuttle service that can take you back and forth to the campus. Hampton Inn and Suites, an official hotel of UMES Athletics.
Hawks trail 26-21 midway through the first half. They've burned. It's been a day where I think the Hawks have played with the red energy on the offensive end, but it's Morgan State's defensive pressure that's making the difference.
Yeah, it's causing the Hawks to get deep in the shot clock on the offensive end, and sometimes they've been forcing the shot. That results in a couple of turnovers, and that therefore the difference in the basketball game of 5 points.
So we'll see what the Hawks do. Remember, two fouls is on the bench. They weren't, but he's going to sit for a little bit. He certainly didn't want to pick up two fouls here in the Oregon State. Not going to complain about that.
Big guy in the game.
Oregon State working offensively with Cedric Blossom, feeding into the right corner for a Carr three, and it pops out. That's the handle. Instead, back to Carr. He's fouled on the way to the tin.
That's the second or third time that Morgan has done that. The Hawks have got a rebound, come down with it, tripped.
Well,
by Morgan.
I don't say this for a con to the Hawks. It's more of a compliment to Morgan State. Both teams are playing at a high level, but I think Morgan State won. More right.
Yeah. And usually that shows on the offensive glass and getting the basketball.
Well, yeah, the offensive rebounds and then the energy with in that part.
Basketball.
They're making it tough. Good. Shore played a lot of times. 51-53. But the Hawks have not State freeze the 99-2000 and 2000-2001. So it's been almost two decades. And if they were to win tonight, they would do that after sweeping the ball. As Martin traveled with the basketball from the top of the arc. They disagree. He might have tried to draw in contact.
He was trying to go to contact.
But I don't think he traveled. Either way.
It's an easy out call. He doesn't have to call.
Yeah. Mark Blackman into the ball game. He's more of a lower out of bounds. Morgan State makes a silly mistake. HU on top. Burn through it from out of bounds in the backcourt to out of bounds in the front court. Rivera somehow maintained his dribble through three defenders, gave to Copeland, who commits an offensive foul. Cedric Blossom taps his chest and said, "That was all me." Yeah, it was. Yeah. Way to get your feet set.
The full court press caused Rivera to get out of control a little bit, and thus forcing the Hawks to go out of control. And Copeland, wow, he's got two fouls, and now he's sitting the last 7 minutes of the first half.
So Randall and Blackman will have to step up, and Andino, also, or rather Rivera, also out there. In the left corner, up top, drives to the paint, dishes off to Blossom, two-hand jam. 30-21, MSU on top. Harton in the backcourt, feeds Thomas Rivera. Rivera in the backcourt, right around the timeline, gives it to Randall, who's almost lost control. Instead, Martin left corner. Boy, Morgan State is playing with some kind of energy on defense.
On defense, yeah. It's not good, playing extremely well.
Rivera through the left lane with a dish off when he shouldn't have. He was overly selfless, but Randall made the better play.
Good play by Randall.
Carr into the right corner. A couple passes exchanged. Pretlow around to the left side, then gets it back. Back to the right side. Three from Horn. Too short. Rebound to the weak side over the rim. Put back up, and a foul on the way up.
No, that's gone.
It goes on Randall. Eighth foul on the Hawks in the first half, and two on Randall.
I'm not mistaken. That's Simpson's rebound in there where he's come from the weak side and put that up. Somebody there.
More often than not, if you're on the wing or in the corner and you miss a shot, it's going to go to the weak side on the rebound.
That's about 90% of the time.
Yeah. You've got to do a better job. No matter which team you play for, you've got to do a better job on the backside of the play.
That just shows the aggressiveness that Morgan is playing with right now, going for the weak side rebound.
Simpson hit them both. 32-23, Morgan State. They lead by nine. 5:30 left in the first half as Rivera in the forecourt calls out the offensive play. Hawks are going small at the moment with two of their big forwards in foul trouble. We talked about it in the pregame. Got to have a few other guys stepping up in conference play. 10 to shoot. Rivera, good crossover. Left elbow, jump shot, too strong. Pack raises up and puts it back up and in. Derrico Pack with a beautiful job timing that jump, corralling the offensive rebound at its highest point and the good touch to knock it in.
Yeah, good tip in. That's a great offensive rebound coming from the weak side by Peck.
He just out-jumped everybody. 32-25. Left baseline, Blossom backs down. Kicks out for a three, and Thomas buries it.
Thomas got a little cock on that jump shot where he cocks the basketball. Great rotation. Nothing but net.
35-25. UMES, a futile first half offensively. Morgan State, who's not averaging much offensively. In fact, they're only scoring 63.5 points per game. That's fewer than the 65 a game that Maryland Eastern Shore averages. But it's MSU out in front by 10 as Rivera slips through the right baseline and threw a pass to Peck, who bobbled it out of bounds.
The Bears are doing it with defense, though, Brendan, on this end, but a great deal of energy and desire on the defensive end.
4:16 left in the first half. Blackman and Rivera out. Frost and Andino back on the floor. Again, no Elliott, no Copeland for probably the rest of the first half. In the half court. Carr bounces right side where Martez Cameron has it. Back to the top of the arc. Gillespie into the left corner. Carr caught it off balance. Gillespie zings a pass to the right side to Cameron. Back to Gillespie. Fakes left. Back to the right side. Gillespie open three. No. And then a foul on the rebound attempt. Check that. That was Cameron on the three-pointer attempt.
Right. But Coach Bozeman using a freshman rotation of two guards. They're playing two guards together.
offensive foul on that rebound, and we have a timeout. 3:52 left in the first half. Right now it's Morgan State 35, Maryland Eastern Shore 25. This is the Hawks Sports Network on sfnsports.net.
Ah, please, God, give me a sign.
What do you need, son?
God?
No, I'm your Signs by Tomorrow customer representative, but I can help you.
When you need to put your business in the best possible light, Signs by Tomorrow can get the job done and done right away. From lighted signs to vehicle graphics, the new Easton location is now open at Dover Road and Route 50. Call 410-770-9.
and haven't been able to give you any updates on live stats, but hopefully we'll have numbers for you at halftime to be able to give you. I think Morgan State is certainly out shooting the Hawks. I would argue they're probably out rebounding them as well, and that's got a big reason as to why they're up by 8.
I think you're correct.
No.
Just not quite enough so far from UMES. They have played at a good level, but not quite matched the intensity. The Bears playing right now like they wanted a little bit more. Andino, Blackman, Caldwell, Martin, and Peck. It could basically be a five-guard set, though Peck can play in the post, but he turns it over right wing. 1 minute to play in the half. Deflected on the way up the floor, Morgan State controls. Blossom gives over in the top of the arc and back up top to Pretlow. He'll kill some clock. Todd Bozeman pacing the sideline in front of the orange-clad bench, telling his team, hey, let's kill some time instead of be too aggressive here. 30-second difference between game and shot clock. Horn from the left side, back up top to Pretlow, who wants to press the issue, blocked by Peck in the lane. 3-on-1. Andino lobs to Blackman, who pulls toward the corner. Back to Martin, fakes from the right wing. No look pass to Peck underneath. A beautiful feed and a better finish. 41-35.
And Peck has inspired the Hawks with some great enthusiasm and several nice offensive plays, plus a defensive block now.
And he also redeemed himself from that turnover. 12 seconds to play in the half as Blackman starts to pressure Pretlow near midcourt. 7 to play. Pretlow to the right side, almost threw it away for Horn. Horn wants to go to the corner. Carr, catch, shoot. 3, no good. Blackman the rebound, and that's it for the first half. The closing 2 minutes, pretty good from the Hawks, and they keep it within 6 points as they go to the locker room at halftime.
Yeah, from Andino and Peck, two sources that we didn't expect.
So a 6-point effort, 41-35. The Hawks needed to go really rely on their bench, as you said, because Elliott and Copeland got in foul trouble. Timeout here from the Heights Athletic Center, but when we come back, it's halftime, and we'll give you as much as we can in terms of halftime stats. We're hoping to have those numbers for you from our sports info office. Back in a moment. This is the Hawks Sports Network on sfmsports.net.
In 1942, Eleanor flipped her wig about Geico saving her moolah on her motor insurance.
Hey, man. In 1969, Ace saved enough dough with Geico to go to Woodstock. His only memory? The savings.
In 1984, Stephanie, like, saved. Like, majorly on her car insurance with Geico. It was, like, so totally righteous.
Over the past 75 years, the expressions have changed, but one thing hasn't. Saving money with Geico.
Green light. Hey, girl. School zone. I'm getting hungry. Car changing lanes. You want to meet me for pizza? Stop sign. Intersection clear. Yeah, street. Pizza sounds good. Ball in street? Girl in street!
It's hard to concentrate on two things at once, like texting and driving. Stop the text. Stop the wrecks. How will you stop texting and driving? Tell us at StopTextStopWrecks.org. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
Every golfer wants to play better golf. Whether it's fixing a slice off the tee or learning how to accurately read a green, there's always room to make your game just a little bit stronger. The key to better golf is the best instruction, and Golf Digest is the only place you can learn from the game's hottest pros. Ernie Els, Phil Mickelson, Tiger Woods, and many more. Subscribe today, and for just $14.97, you'll get 12 issues of Golf Digest with easy-to-follow tips and techniques, reviews of top equipment, information on the best places to play, even our quick reference pocket tips in every issue. Order Golf Digest now and we'll send you a DVD featuring renowned instructor Jim McLean. It's absolutely free with your paid subscription. Learn Jim's favorite drills to help isolate your problem areas and practice plans that will help fine-tune your game. Subscribe to Golf Digest today for this limited-time DVD offer. Call 800-248-5568. That's 800-248-5568 to get your subscription to Golf Digest. 800-248-5568.
This is UMES Basketball on the Hawks Sports Network, powered by SFMSports.net. The All-Access Halftime Show starts now.
Halftime here in Princess Anne, Maryland, 41-35. The Hawks trail by six at halftime, and it's probably better that they trail by six because they closed the first half with better energy than they did in the beginning of the game. And you certainly don't want to see the team down, but that being said, you saw a little bit of a shift in momentum as they kind of went into that locker room.
And actually, they're doing it with two starters sitting on the bench. You know, Caldwell and not Caldwell, but
Copeland
and Dominique. So that's a big plus. And we got some contributions from Peck and Andino.
Well, again, we don't quite have numbers yet for you in the first half, and hopefully we'll have those for you soon. So we can't give you any live stat updates. But, I mean, I think the best thing we could tell you is, look, Bobby Collins kind of had his hand forced because Elliott and Copeland picked up those fouls, and they weren't early fouls in the sense that they didn't come early in the first half, but they're early in that they had to sit out most of the first half. I mean, a good
last eight or nine minutes. And really, you know, anybody will tell you in basketball, the first 5 to 8 minutes are very important. The last 5 or 8 minutes are really important of each half and each game.
All the more reason to be encouraged that the Hawks were able to close the gap without them on the floor.
Those time periods set the tone.
Jericho Peck came off the bench and really made a nice effort.
Yeah.
Had a couple of baskets, a really nice offensive tip in and on a putback. He's pulled down a couple offensive rebounds and a block shot on the defensive end of the floor. Andino, a couple of three-point buckets. Again, you can see the pieces are there. You just hope that the shots start to fall. Being on their home floor, you want the Hawks to try to generate some momentum here.
That's right. But you got to give Morgan credit. They moved the basketball extremely well on offense, and on defense, they're playing very, very tough. The Hawks are not getting too many overlooks.
I know you haven't seen every game all year, but I guess I'm curious your thoughts on the differences that you've seen early in the season when this team played compared to...
Well, I think we're playing better. I mean, that's my overall. I mean, because there's more pieces that have gotten experience, but we're still looking. If you notice, from somebody to take over the point guard spot to run the show for us.
Hawks trail by 6 points at the intermission, 41-35. Morgan State came out of the gate, and they went right into that full court zone press. And I think that bothered UMES a little bit early on with a couple of turnovers, though the score didn't reflect it. They also were really pressured by a zone defense in the forecourt. And it was kind of interesting because if you talk to Bobby Collins about his offensive philosophy, he wants to be an offense that works inside out. And if they take three-pointers as a result of having repeated good looks inside, that's fine. But he doesn't want to be the kind of team that forces open looks from the outside.
Right.
That being said, of late, it's been a good three-point shooting team. And so Morgan State said, hey, we're going to go in a zone defense and try to force you to shoot from the outside. And so far, it's been effective.
Very effective. That's because they've been so quick to the ball, and they're really concentrating on the Hawks' three-point shooter. You know, Devin Martin has not had very, very few good looks.
Well, I think he's the guy who's always circled on somebody's scouting report. And it's no offense to Dominique Elliott, and it's no offense to Bakari Copeland. They're both playing at a pretty high level. But when Devin Martin is playing well, this team seems to play at a better level overall. They're a better team when Devin's at his best, and if you can shut him down, it makes him a little bit more vulnerable.
Yeah, that's correct. You know, it also opens up when he's playing well. It opens up a lot of things for other people. What I really am happy to see though is somebody like Peck coming off the bench and making contributions in all aspects of the game for Coach Collins.
I think Dante Caldwell is growing too. Again, I'm not entirely sure what his stat line is tonight, but he's more involved even when he's not scoring. He hit a three-point shot, but he's kind of in a rhythm at this point. He's starting to feel like he's more of a routine flow of the offense.
Right, he's part of the team. He knows he's going to get a play a certain amount of times. He's going to do, and if he's playing well, he gets more time, so he's become a part of the team.
Okay, we'll take a timeout when we come back. We'll give you a look at the MEAC standings if we still don't have stats at that point. About halfway through our halftime intermission. 41-35, Morgan State by 6. This is the Hawk Sports Network on sfmsports.net.
Stop taking selfies and do something useful with your smartphone.
First, let me take a selfie.
Get the TuneIn app and listen to any sfmsports.net broadcast from anywhere in the world. Yes, even there. The TuneIn app gets you instant access to our live streams and on-demand content. And did I mention, it's free. That's right. Download it today at the App Store or on Google Play and take sfmsports.net with you anywhere. But please stop taking me to the bathroom. I'm tired of that.
Bobby, you're here again.
Yeah, my doctor told me to reduce stress at work, so I come to Buffalo Wild Wings to eat lunch and watch sports. I get to pick one of 7 entrees, like sandwiches and salads, plus one of 7 sides.
Well, I like sides.
It's so affordable, I could finally take a vacation.
Where are you going to go?
Here, Tim, here.
Introducing the new B-Dubs Fast Break Lunch Menu, starting at a new low price. Dine in or order takeout weekdays between 11 and 2. Participation and availability may vary. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
Peninsula Regional Medical Center is proud to be recognized as a national healthcare leader, delivering exceptional healthcare by exceptional people. The professional staff at PRMC is equipped to handle most injuries and illnesses that are non-life-threatening and can deliver immediate medical attention without an appointment. To get more information and up to the second wait times, visit peninsula.org. PRMC, proud to be the official healthcare provider of the UMES Hawks.
The Hampton Inn & Suites Fruitland Salisbury South is passionate about getting it right. Their promise to you includes a clean, comfortable hotel room, located only 7.5 miles from the University of Maryland Eastern Shore. Also conveniently located within walking distance of 5 different restaurants, plus a shuttle service that can take you back and forth to the campus. Hampton Inn & Suites, an official hotel of UMES Athletics.
The UMES Hawks All Access Halftime Show continues on sfmsports.net.
Maryland Eastern Shore trails 41-35 at halftime to the Morgan State Bears, who just now came out of the locker room. Hawks are taking a couple of extra minutes to go over things with this 6-point hole that they're facing. Morgan State certainly looks like a better team than the 3-12 record they've put up so far.
Yeah.
I had a chance to see them play a couple times when they were on ESPN3, opened the season at Virginia. Right. They played against Cincinnati. Those games were both nationally televised affairs, and you kind of knew this was a pretty athletic team, and they've showed it here in the early going, even though they're not a particularly big team.
No, they're not.
Even their bigger forwards like Philippe Carr, guys that can really play.
Yeah, they're more of a what you call a balanced team where everybody can just do about everything. The guys across the front are all about the same size. That are not, you know, they don't have a 6'10 guy in the middle. Their guards are all about the same size. Coach Bozeman rotates those people in and out, so he keeps the same thing. So they're athletic all through the first, I'd say, 8 guys coming off. They're going to win some games in the MEAC.
Well, we take a look at the MEAC standings. Who do you like so far and where they're at?
Well, we talked about Hampton early, and obviously anybody that's 3-0 or 3 is off to a great start. So Hampton and Norfolk are off to a start. I personally would not count this Morgan team out. Down the road, I wouldn't count the Hawks out at all either, because they got a chance to be. Anybody's got a chance to be in there, but I would not count either one of these two teams out being in the top tier of the MEAC.
How about from a coaching perspective, of the coaches that you've gotten a chance to know a little bit in the MEAC, which coach stands out to you as being a guy that could take his team from being an average team to a great team?
Well, the guy right here, he's done it already.
Yeah, Todd Bozeman.
Yeah, Todd Bozeman has done it several times. So that's where I would put my, if I were a betting guy,
Are you a betting guy? I hear the Powerball is $1.3 billion.
That's what it is, yeah. You're not betting on anything there. You're just praying that you get the right ticket.
Yeah, I hear you. Just remember me when you win.
I will. Don't worry.
All right.
And 500,000 people that will be calling my number.
That's right. I mean? That's right. Just don't tell any of them first. 41-35, our score at halftime, and we'll take our final timeout. And we come back a couple minutes from now, Morgan State and UMES will be ready to go in the second half. Can Dominique Elliott and Bakari Copeland get this team off to a good, quick start in the second half? Or will Morgan State continue to ride some of that late first half momentum? We'll find out next. This is the Hawks Sports Network on sfmsports.net.
Times sure have changed since Geico started saving people money over 75 years ago. We didn't have video games like today, but that's not to say we didn't have fun. One of my favorite games was Don't Get Kicked by the Goat. Now that's some real excitement, especially when someone lost. Yep, back then we knew two things, how to have a good time, and that Geico was always a good deal.
Geico, saving people money on car insurance for over 75 years.
Are you going to kill someone tonight? Drunk drivers do every night. Maryland law enforcement agencies are stopping drunk drivers in your community with sobriety checkpoints and intense patrols. It's Checkpoint Strike Force. So drive sober and always wear your seatbelt. Drunk driving, over the limit, under arrest. Visit CheckpointStrikeForce.net for more information.
Sponsored by the Maryland State Highway Administration and this station.
Do you need a break, a getaway? Plan a visit to Hyatt Place Dewey Beach in Delaware. Lay back, relax with your toes in the sand, and unwind to the sounds of the ocean. Please your palate with a delicious meal at Cape Hasa Restaurant on the bay while taking in the sights of a beautiful sunset. It's time to get away and make that getaway to the Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. Call 302-864-9100 or visit HyattPlaceDeweyBeach.com. Make a lifetime of memories in your own backyard at Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. That's Hyatt Place Dewey Beach on Facebook and Instagram.
Please, God, give me a sign.
What do you need, son?
God?
No, I'm your Signs by Tomorrow customer representative, but I can help you.
When you need to put your business in the best possible light, Signs by Tomorrow can get the job done and done right away. From lighted signs to vehicle graphics, the new Easton location is now open at Dover Road and Route 50. Call 410-770-9825. At Signs by Tomorrow, we don't just provide signs, we provide peace of mind.
41-35 as we start the second half between Morgan State and Maryland Eastern Shore. Thanks for tuning in. Before we get to the action, let's pause 10 seconds for a station identification. This is the Hawk Sports Network on sfmsports.net.
Second half of action.
Alongside local star Dave Bird, I'm Brendan Gulick, 41-35, as we get ready for the second half. It's Maryland Eastern Shore on offense, working right to left. Martin in the right corner. He raises from three, and he's just a little short. Elliott strong on the offensive putback, but missed it. Rebound pulled in by Bakari. Copeland in a third shot up and in. How about that? Elliott and Copeland both in on the first offensive play.
That's right. There's Hawks showed her size advantage on the first offensive play of the second half.
41-37, the two guys playing with two fouls apiece. And again, we apologize for not having live stats for you today. There have been stat problems all day, and there continue to be problems. Hopefully those will be worked out sooner than later.
It's called technical difficulty.
That's right. Blossom backs down right corner, kicks to Cameron for three, and he knocks it in with just 3 seconds left of the shot clock. 44-37, Morgan State out front.
Here's Cameron, a freshman from Chicago.
Martin on the right wing. Bounce pass down Dominique Elliott. To Bakari Copeland for three, and he misfired. Bears got the rebound, and Cameron comes up to the right side, into the corner, and back up to Carr. He wants a three, and he missed it left. Copeland skies for the carom.
We were actually just told right after we made that comment that the stats will not be available all night long as Martin races to the rim for two. So we'll just do our best to give you what we can. But 44-39, Maryland Eastern Shore by five. In the right corner, on his way to the hoop, missing, and a really late whistle drawn will send Rashawn Simpson to the free throw line. That was the official on the far side of the floor who was furthest away from the play that blew the whistle late. And that sent some of the Hawk fans grumbling.
And a little bit of contact.
Rashawn Simpson.
Not much.
Got the first free throw, 45-39. 18-19 left in the second half. Up and good again for the San Diego kid. By the way, Derrick Henry, since you were so eager to find out the score, Derrick Henry of Alabama, the Heisman Trophy winner, ripped off a 50-yard touchdown run. So right now, Alabama leads 7-0 over Clemson. Late first quarter of the national championship game on the gridiron tonight.
Yeah, that's what Heisman players do.
Elliott feeds Martin underneath. Lays it in with a right hand for two. 46-41, the seniors off to a good start here this half.
Stepping up.
2 minutes gone. Blossom goes to the right side. Carr zings it into the corner. Pretlow back to Carr, who passes almost off the forehead and afro of Martez Cameron. Instead, he deflected it out of bounds back to the Hawks. Cameron reactionarily pulled his head out of the way.
Yeah, he was trying to
hit his hand anyways.
He was trying to duck that fastball.
Frost back out there to start the half at point guard. Right wing dribbles right-handed, finds Elliott. Tom will raise from there. He does. And it's a little short. Rebound goes over the top of the rim. Copeland can't pull it down. Instead, Carr and the Bears. Morgan State races up the floor. Cameron bounces back to the left arc. Carr around the top, into the left corner. Passes off Cameron for three. Cameron too short. Rebound tipped to Devin Martin and Maryland Eastern Shore. Devin dribbling right-handed. No-look pass underneath. Elliott, two-hand flush.
Little eye contact by Devin that time. Great pass.
Like a quarterback looked off the defender, even though he and Elliott were on the same page. It's a 46-43 ball game. UMES pulls within three. Top of the arc for Morgan State. Carr to his left. Cameron bounces low post to Blossom, who's doubled. Up top to Carr for three. Yes. Philippe Carr hits another one. 49-43. And actually, we're now just getting word that his name is pronounced Philip. I apologize for that. Frost to the left side. Bakari Copeland right back up top to the freshman guard. Ahmad bounces high key. Elliott fakes left, spins in the paint, forces it up and in. Dominic Elliott keeps on working.
Right. Good patience in the lane by Dominic Elliott.
49-45, Hawks down four. Pretlow runs the point. This Morgan State team is one of the best teams in the country and leads the conference in fewest turnovers per game. They are also best in the conference in turnover margin. Three ball missed from Carr up top and saved out of bounds just barely by Ahmad Frost. Morgan State disagrees, and they are vehement in that feeling.
The whole bunch got up, so they must have saw something.
Frost up top. To the left, fakes, back out to Copeland. Thought about an NBA three. Instead, Elliott the paint. No look, fade to Martin, who cuts backdoor.
Yeah. Wow. Great cut to the basket by Devin Martin. Good assist by Dominic.
That is a hot head coach over in front of the Morgan State bench. Todd Bozeman is continuing to walk out onto the floor, pointing at the officials and barking. He is not happy. 49-47, Hawks within two. 15-13 left in the second half. You're listening to the Hawks Sports Network on SFNSports.net.
Peninsula Regional Medical Center is proud to be recognized as a national healthcare leader, delivering exceptional healthcare by exceptional people. The professional staff at PRMC is equipped to handle most injuries and illnesses that are non-life-threatening and can deliver immediate medical attention without an appointment.
To get more information and up to the second wait times, visit peninsula.org. PRMC, proud to be the official healthcare provider of the UMES Hawks.
The Courtyard by Marriott on Route 13 in Salisbury offers comfortable rooms and meeting spaces, as well as always superior customer service in a great location near the mall. Call 410-742-4405 and ask for details about their special UMES athletics rate. The Courtyard by Marriott in Salisbury, an official hotel of UMES Athletics and a proud sponsor of Hawks Basketball from SFMSports.net.
Get UMES Hawks Basketball anywhere. Listen on your phone with the TuneIn app. Search SFM Sports Channel 2.
Maryland Eastern Shore down only 49-47. Playing well here in the second half. It's a two-point game. Rivera pressuring the ball in the forecourt. Morgan State's got it. Underneath the Blossom, and he finished at the rim. Pretlow, Horn, and Blossom, the three guys that touched the ball, 51-47.
Yeah, come out of a timeout very well that time for the Bears.
Oregon State on the season, 3-12. Maryland Eastern Shore having a tough year as well, 3-14. Is the ball loose on the floor under the basket, and everybody dives on it. Jump ball goes the other way.
I'm not sure where Rivera was going that time.
It's been a second half with, I would say, a lot of offense, certainly a lot of open looks, and much more control in the foul category. Only one foul the whole half.
Yeah, we like that part.
That's right. One on Dominique Elliott, his third, I believe. Here's a three ball right side, and it just missed short. Horn couldn't find the net. Instead, Martin up the floor for the Hawks. Behind the back dribble twice. Randall feeds to the right side. Rivera now to Elliott, right corner. Dom drives baseline, and he's held by Cedric Blossom.
Yeah, that's what Coach Collins trying to get Rivera to do to begin with. Let's start the offense inside and then out.
Timeout on the floor with 14:23 left in our game. Maryland Eastern Shore trails 51-47. Back in a moment. This is the Hawks Sports Network on SFMSports.net.
Consider the cup holder. There's probably one feeling empty next to you right now. No Pepsi, no hope. Just look at it, won't you? All across the country, cup holders are being neglected. Instead of Pepsi, they're being filled with loose change or crumpled up receipts. But you can help. Get a Pepsi and refresh a cup holder's life. Our thirsts are counting on it. In fact, I'm having one right now. That is refreshing. Pepsi, refresh yourself. Refill your cup holder.
Bobby, you here again?
Yeah, my doctor told me to reduce stress at work, so I come to Buffalo Wild Wings to eat lunch and watch sports. I get to pick one of seven entrees, like sandwiches and salads, plus one of seven sides.
Well, I like sides.
It's so affordable, I can finally take a vacation.
Where are you going to go?
Here, Tim, here.
Introducing the new B-Dubs Fast Break Lunch Menu, starting at a new low price. Dine in or order takeout weekdays between 11 and 2. Participation and availability may vary. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
This is Hawks Basketball from SFMSports.net.
Amen.
Oregon State 51, Maryland Eastern Shore 47. In a tightly contested ball game here at home for Maryland Eastern Shore. Only 14 games left on the regular season schedule, and eight of them are on their home floor, including tonight's. After starting the year with 14 of their first 17 on the road, it led to a 3-14 record, and of the three wins, two of them
in this building. And I want to be here at the Hype Center, so we need to get some games here.
Thomas Rivera trying to inbound baseline, gets it into Dominique Kelly. Hawks trail by four. Two seniors right wing as Martin dribbles. Outside the arc, pulls up, a step inside, and puts it in. Deep two for Devin Martin. He's had a good day. Again, no idea how many points he's got, but I would definitely say he's in double figures.
Yes.
Devin Martin's been a big part of the offense. He comes up with a steal here. Devin one-on-one all the way up the floor, and it's out of bounds off of air. A lot of players trailing him up the floor. Devin tried to cross over in the paint. And Dino back in the game for Shane Randall. And Horn checks out of the ball game
I think the new guy on the floor was Kyle Thomas.
It looked like Martin had something hanging off his shorts as he ran up the floor. It almost looked like a chain or something, but maybe it was just a piece of fuzz. It was a little distracting.
It's a thread.
Kari Copeland lays it up and in. I couldn't quite tell. It doesn't seem to be there anymore. But it's tied at 51. 13:30 left in the game. Plenty of time left for both of these two teams to try to make their move. Carr to the left side. Free ball coming, and Pretlow's too long. Martin mistimed his rebound jump, but the ball was tipped right back to him as he tippy-toes that sideline. Back up the floor. Martin all the way to the hoop, lost the ball, out of bounds. And you're right, it is a thread, and it's still attached.
Yeah.
Yeah, something got caught on his shorts and it started to unspool a little bit.
A finger or something.
51-51. Inbound to the baseline. Thomas Rivera lobs it into the high key. Copeland bounces underneath where Elliott tried to get it. Thankfully, Andino pulled it in right in front of us before someone came crashing into us. Andino, left wing, lobs up top to Rivera. Tennis shoot. Thomas, the junior point guard who played in front of family and friends at Columbia last week, all the way through the hoop, but can't miss. I shouldn't say can't hit from point blank range. Blossom saw an opening right through the middle of the defense up and in.
Too easy. Right down the throat.
Defensive
ball
breakdown.
Ball fake by Blossom, but still. And they're back in this full court pressure now with Bennett all the way up top of it.
53-51, Morgan State by two, but a tight game. Hawks played well coming out of the shoot here this half. Rivera splits the defense and draws a foul. He's held. Goes on Dominique Elliott. That's not good. Cameron. Artez Cameron picks up the foul, his second. I saw 32. Just mentally went to Dominique Elliott. That would have been his fourth. Thankfully, not the case. Copeland circling around, top of the key. Finds Elliott, who was blocked on a dunk attempt. And the ball goes out of bounds off Dom.
In his hand.
That was impressive by Morgan State.
Wow.
Kyle Thomas said, I'm not letting you posterize me. No chance. So the Hawks go back on defense, down by a pair. 12-12 left in the game. Gillespie slings a pass left side. Up to the top of the arc, Thomas back to Gillespie right wing. Into the corner now. Morgan State works around the perimeter. They have yet to penetrate the defense this time. Thomas spinning through, lobs underneath to nobody. In fact, Thomas thought, Rashawn Simpson, who he was looking for, was pointing up and saying, hey, dude, shoot the ball.
Yeah.
He turned around and he goes,
5 feet from the basket.
What are you passing to me for? You are open. Time out on the floor, 53-51. Hawks down two. 11:57 to go in the game. Hope they can hang in there. Glad you're with us tonight here on the Hawks Sports Network on sfmsports.net.
Have you heard? Proactive is new and better than ever. Stay tuned for a million bottle giveaway and you'll also receive free shipping. Do you have troubled skin, acne? Well, we have great news. With new Proactive, your acne can heal and you can prevent new breakouts from happening. Be one of the first to try it by giving us a call at 1-800-669-8096. Because we're going to let a million people try new Proactive risk-free. Get two free gifts and also receive free shipping when you call right now. You heard it. Be one of the first to try new and better than ever.
63-63. Buckle up. 4:12 left to go in the game. What do you think, partner? It's been fun.
We're right there where we talked about, and we're looking at a close game down the stretch no matter what. The big players will make big plays down here. We'll see if the Hawks can come out with a home court victory.
Ken, we apologize. We've had no live stats all game. Had technical difficulties on that end, and we won't be able to give you stats for the contest today. Only thing I can tell you is Andino's got three threes.
We do remember that. Sure.
He's been a nice today off the bench for Bobby Collins.
And Philip Carr's got a lot of rebounds for
yeah, he's been all
Morgan. We do know that.
Rivera feeds Martin up top. Catch and shoot, got triple. It. Bang! Devin Martin with a big three-point shot, and the Hawks are up by three. 66-63, and now we'll see if the Hawks can keep that momentum defensively. Morgan State led this one fairly decisively. It was a six-point game at halftime. The Hawks trailed by as many as 12. Blossom up top, passes back to Pretlow on the left side, and all of a sudden Morgan State has lost a little bit of their mojo.
Yeah.
In the right corner, two to shoot. Carr has to put up a three, and he missed it. Of course, Devin Martin brings in the rebound, slowly tells Thomas Rivera, hey, keep an eye on the clock and let's be smart.
Now that 2-3 zone is calling Morgan a great deal of problems.
66-63, UMES. Martin gets it up top, one out of three, but instead drove, picked up his dribble, back to Copeland, who bobbled it. He needs a hand. Finds Rivera, eight to shoot, 3:05 to play. Thomas lobs to Elliott. He had Martin cutting, but Elliott puts it up. Nothing but net. 18-footer from the right baseline, 68-63, and the Hawks have a five-point edge.
Now that 18-footer step back is his shot on the baseline.
Cash money. Pretlow up top as the Hawks try to maintain the defensive energy. They want to win so bad, and Morgan State is not going to give them anything. MSU better than their 3-12 record, too. Baseline drive, a kick out, a Gillespie three right side. It was dead on, but too strong, and Elliott went up for the rebound, was fouled from behind. Rashawn Simpson, the senior from San Diego, tried to pull it around Elliott, but he fouled him. That's the sixth foul on Morgan State. They're at the limit. Hawks still with two to give.
Full court pressure now by Morgan. So again, I repeat, the 2-3 zone called Morgan problems. The shot clock has run down the past four possessions down to under five, and they've had a four.
Horn back on the floor, replacing Gillespie. Five-point lead. Rivera into the right corner, lost it out of bounds. Waiting to make the call, and it will go Morgan State's way, and that's the right decision. Thomas kicked it incidentally. Elliott, the senior, goes right over to him, gives him a hug, taps him on the head. Probably wants to rub his belly, do the whole thing. Hey, forget about it. Let it go. Get back and let's play good defense. That's the message there.
He was off his foot. He's still trying to force the issue, going too much to the basket.
UMES last year with one of the biggest turnarounds in program history. This year, they need to play well in conference play to give them something to feel good about. Timeout called for by Morgan State at the 2:14 mark. Last year, an 11-5 mark in conference play, 18-15 overall. It was the best season that this program here at Maryland Eastern Shore has had since the 73-74 season, Coach. And finally, they got some momentum. They had obviously one of the best players, not just in the conference, but in all of mid-major basketball in the country, in Mike Myers. This year, it's been Martin and Elliott that have tried to carry the load. Copeland's resurgence of late has helped, but it doesn't matter when you don't see anything in the left-hand column when you look at the record. If a win today can get something rolling for UMES, they might feel good about the way they can attack conference play. And they're in position, but they got to finish this game with 2:14 to go.
That's right. And if they do that, they hold service on their home court in the conference. They've shown that they can do that. And if they beat this team, then I believe they can beat anybody in the conference, especially here at the Heights.
Is it fair to say that a team like this is still trying to learn how to win games?
Oh, yeah, certainly. You're playing with guys that haven't had much playing. Basically, you're playing with two guys that have played a lot of minutes, and Elliott and Martin. And really, Elliott didn't play a lot of minutes last year because he spent most of the time on the bench in foul trouble. So it's a
It's in progress.
Love the energy off the timeout there. The Hawks sprinted out of their huddle.
Yeah, right on.
20 seconds to shoot for Morgan State. They trail by five. Pretlow up top, trying to work around a screen. He's denied going to his left. Here's Horn, hard for the lane, and a bad bounce pass into the corner is turned over. He threw it right at the foot of his teammate.
Yeah.
Carr couldn't handle it, and it's out of bounds.
Yeah.
Hawks ball in the backcourt, 2 minutes to go.
Yeah, the turnover, big turnover by the Hawks.
But UMES has to make it pay. Got to make it hurt. Five-point edge, 1:50 to play. Elliott wants the ball, low left post extended. Couple jab steps, finally a shot fake, and he bobbled the ball and trapped it. A little over-aggressive there, so the Hawks, no worse for the wear. Turnover, turnover, both ways.
I think Coach Collins didn't want to necessarily go that quick to the basket.
Randall, Rivera, Andino, Martin, and Elliott for UMES. They match up defensively. Here's Pretlow at the point to his left. Dante Pretlow dribbling on the left wing, wanting some help to the middle of the paint. Puts up the right-handed layup. No. Tip back is gunned off the rebound and pulled down by Randall on a miss.
Big rebound. Randall playing in some crunch time. We haven't seen that in a while.
1:23 to play. Copeland is not on the floor right now. Randall's taking his spot. Bakari's got four fouls. He's waiting to check in if needed. But not at the scorer's table. Final minute 12. The Hawks trying to finally get in the win column for the first time since Central Penn on Tuesday, December 22nd. Randall passes to Andino for three. Just missed it with the shot clock expiring. Morgan State the rebound. They're down 5 minutes to go, racing up the floor, and a blocking foul called on Rivera. Probably the right call.
Yeah.
He tried to get his feet set, but I think just by a little bit, he's still moving.
He was moving. I'll give the guys in stripy shirts a pat on the back on that one. That's correct.
Here comes Copeland. Out goes Randall. 55.8 on the clock. Hawks 68. Morgan State 63.
It's still just out of bounds, so nothing wrong with a foul, actually, because he actually saved the bucket.
I think Coach just wanted Bakari's free throw shooting capability on the floor, because if Morgan State doesn't score here, they probably have to foul. On the inbound, into the left corner. Simpson, back up top, hands to Pretlow, who passed it in originally. Pretlow uses a high screen, wants some space. Elliott does a good job denying the high post, 18 to shoot. Simpson forces down low, good pass. Copeland well defended, but it snuck up and in
Blossom.
By Cedric Blossom, three-point game. 68-65, 9 second difference between game and shot clock. The Hawks have the lead, they just got to take a smart shot. They're up by three. Devin Martin dribbling just left of center. Lobs to Elliott near midcourt. Elliott dribbling and finally calls a timeout with exactly 23 seconds left and 14 on the shot clock. And again, you've got a three-point lead, so you can't, unless you commit a stupid foul and a guy hits a miracle three, you can't go down here. So take the right shot offensively, and even if you miss it and Morgan State comes up the floor, you're not going to lose in regulation on a buzzer beater in your head.
Right. They got to be patient under this stand there. They still have 14 seconds, which is a world of time to get off a good shot.
The most important thing right here is to take the right shot.
Yeah, that's
miss
right.
Or make. Use the clock the right way, take the right shot.
Yeah.
Is the obvious answer Devin Martin? Who do you want taking the shot?
Oh, yeah, I would.
Yeah.
That's the obvious one. But I mean, he's a good passer, too, so somebody, if they double him, somebody's going to be open.
Well,
but
Devin,
you need to use the 14 seconds to run it down. That only gives 9 seconds for Morgan to get back and get his shot.
Devin's going to inbound the ball. It's deflected out of bounds by Philip Carr.
Careful.
Hawks with one foul to give. Morgan State at the limit. Philip Carr has to give Devin Martin 3 feet to inbound the basketball. Carr doing jumping jacks in front of him. Martin needs a little help. Lobs it in. Elliott has it. Did he tip it?
No.
Yes, he did. He tipped it out of bounds in front of his own bench. Elliott thought it tipped off of LeBert.
You could tell he touched it. You could tell by the bench's reaction. We didn't have to see any of our, the coaches, too.
That's great defense twice.
Twice in a row. That's extremely tough.
Here we go. I said it earlier. Buckle in. 21 seconds left. Shot clock is off.
Morgan State trails by three. They've got the ball. 15 seconds and counting. Pretlow to his right, to the corner. Gives to Carr, who tried to shoot a three, lost it. Rivera saved it from out of bounds. Hawks in the forecourt, 5 seconds to play. And Devin Martin is fouled and flexes his muscles. Morgan State appears to cough up what would have been a game-tying attempt from the three-point arc.
I'm not that sure that's the absolute best shot though they could get either, because it was way out.
I agree with you. It might not have been the best shot, but I think the idea was that it was actually Kyle Thomas that tried to shoot that. Maybe he thought Rivera was going to foul him, and so he tried to force it and maybe get three free throws. But whatever the case was, I don't want to speculate on his thoughts too much. If Martin hits one free throw here, this could make it big. He's got one and one, and he buries it. Senior steps to the line, and he does what he needs to do. 69-65, Devin Martin hits it, and he's got one more coming. Just 4.4 left.
It's a big win here for the Hawks on their home floor. Where to start
second season. Devin missed the seat, gets the rebound. Pass away. Right. And the Hawks in comeback effort chuck up a win for the Maroon and White. 69-65. A big, big win for UMES. If nothing else, it teaches them that if they play the full 40 minutes, they can come out on top.
Yeah. And the MEAC is wide open.
That's right. That's right. Morgan State, better than their record. This is not a 3-12 team. And I think Maryland Eastern Shore is feeling pretty good about the way this happened tonight. So
yeah.
Bobby Collins comes over and joins us in our Geico All-Access post-game show.
Big win.
Congratulations. I know this is one that's got to feel good.
Feels really good. You know, this time of year, you want to win some games and you want to learn along the way. You know, we just had to learn how to win. We just got to learn. We got a great defensive stop. We made some big plays down the stretch. And Dominic Elliott played like a man, rebounding and hitting big baskets. And you know, in situations like this, your best players got to make the best plays. And Devin Martin made a great play. And I'm just proud of the guys. That's the way we fought and gave ourselves a chance to win. We could have easily quit when we got down 10. We were a little flat, and they just taken it to us, and we kind of got back in it, and our bench really helped us out tonight.
I want to ask you about that Columbia game, because that's the most recent contest. We talked after the Columbia game, and you could see the look on everybody's face. It was one of those, man, we're that close, literally that close.
Yeah.
How did playing that game in your last contest hopefully fuel your guys in a situation like this today?
You know, it's ironic that you asked that question, because I used Columbia as a reference in the locker room. They shot the ball well first half, but they're not accustomed to shooting the ball that well. And I told them, there's no way that they shoot the ball better than Columbia. But we got to make them miss, and I hope that they miss. So I was very proud of the effort and the intensity that we played with second half.
Okay, well, we held service at home, Bob, on our home court. We have to do that to be in the MEAC competition. Hey, Morgan just lost to Hampton by three in overtime. Just proves it us, I think, you have proven it. I think you said it all along, that the MEAC is a wide-open league, and the team who wants it the most has a great shot at it.
Absolutely. There's a lot of parity in this league. Every night you got to come and play, and we know that we got to get better, and you know, my rotations, and you know, I kind of know what I want to do at least. And I'm just pleased and proud at the effort that we gave for the last 10 minutes of this game.
I was going to ask you. Derek Opek came in a spot in the first half that was tough, because it wasn't early foul trouble, but Dom Elliott and Bakari Copeland picked up two fouls, and they basically had to sit for 8 or 9 minutes in that first half. Can you reference the effort that Derek Opek gave you in those crucial minutes?
Well, we know he's battle-tested. We've been waiting for him to play like that for a long time, and he's just got to play relaxed. And, you know, I'm intense, and I told him I'm intense and
really?
I'm really passionate. So don't worry about what I say. Just listen to what I'm saying. And if I'm saying something to you, then that means I trust you. But you just got to do it with a little bit more intensity like I have.
Right.
So I'm just pleased that he made those plays, and I'm proud of him, because he needs some confidence. And now we know we can play with him down the stretch, and he can make some plays. He just got to have confidence in himself.
There's a lot of happy people in the Hutch Athletic Center tonight, but nobody with a bigger smile than Bobby Collins. Congratulations on the win.
Yeah, man.
All right. We'll have more with our Geico All Access post-game show when we come back. This is
is the Hawks Sports Network on sfmsports.net.
In 1942, Eleanor flipped her wig about